I had indicated earlier that I would show you what the linear relationship looks like, so let's go ahead and spend a few moments doing that now. And what I'll do is I'll go ahead and graph the relationship between hours media and college GPA for our 20 people. So to do that, we want to go to Graphs, and then go to Legacy Dialogues, and then down here towards the bottom, select Scatter Dot. And then notice Simple Scatter has the box around it. We want to go ahead and go with this default option. So go ahead and click Define. And then here, I'll put college GPA in my Y-axis box, and I'll put hours media in my X-axis box. Now, if you wanted to, you could put hours media in the Y-axis and college GPA in the X-axis. In other words, flip these variables, and that would be fine as well. Next, we'll click OK. And then here we get a graph, which is output. And notice here I have all these circles here. There are actually 20 of these circles here where each circle represents the values for a given individual in my data set. And the way to read this is, if I double click this for a moment, this circle here, notice how on my x-axis variable, the horizontal axis, which we also can think of as x, this is labeled hours media. So here is my hours media variable. And over here, this circle, notice it looks like it's about 30 hours of media, this individual. This is one person's score on hours of media, how much media they watched. And then if you scroll over here to the y-axis labeled college GPA, we can see that their GPA was somewhere around more or less 2.3, maybe 2.35, but somewhere in there. So this point here is high on hours of media, if you notice that. They're all the way to the right. But they're low on college GPA as they're way down here. These other two points are high on hours media, but they're low on college GPA. Next, notice these points over here. This point is low on hours media. They're somewhere around 7 or so, but they're high on GPA. If you notice, they're close to 4. This person is fairly low on hours media, and they're fairly high on GPA, and so on. And then these people in the middle, they're moderate on hours of media, and they're moderate on their GPA, as far as our GPA was measured, which is about from 2 to 4 here. Notice this characterizes a negative relationship. High on one variable, low on the other. Or low on that variable, high on the other. That's how we define a negative relationship. And there's one last thing we can do here. If we right-click this plot, and a shortcut menu opens here, and if we go ahead and select Add Fit Line at Total, click on that. And then here, we're going to select Linear, and then Close, and you'll see here this line, which is used to represent or fit the data points in general. And notice that a straight line is applied. This is exactly what we're doing here with Pearson correlation. We're using a correlation that estimates the linear or straight line relationship. And these points, they do a pretty good job of fitting a straight line here, as opposed to a situation where we don't have a linear relationship. And if you think of something like a parabola, if we had dots like this, and they came around like a horseshoe or a U upside down, that would be a non-linear relationship, and we would not want to use Pearson's R for that. But in many situations, our points do fall in a pattern that mimics a straight line relationship, as opposed to some non-linear relationship like a parabola. This concludes the presentation on correlation in SPSS. Thanks for watching.